The Russian Air Force will arm its Su-57 stealth fighter with a hypersonic missile, as per news in the state media. An unnamed official told TASS, in accordance with Russia's state armament program for 2018 to 2027, Su-57 jet fighters will be equipped with hypersonic missiles. As per reports, the hypersonic missile arming the Su-57 will be a variant of Kinzhal air-to-surface missiles. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes why hypersonic missiles won't be able to save Russian Su-57 fighter. Let's get started. The Kinzhal, or Dagger, was one of the weapons the Russian President Vladimir Putin unveiled in his State of the Nation address earlier this year. An animated video that played during Putin's speech showed the missile being launched from a MiG-31. The video depicted the missile striking what seemed like an American warship. A few days after Putin's speech, the Russian Defense Ministry stated that the Kinzhal missile was launched from a MiG-31 aircraft that took off from an airfield in southwestern Russia. As per it, the launch went according to plan. The hypersonic missile hit its target. A footage was released showing two pilots running towards a MiG-31 carrying Kinzhal missiles. The footage further shows the missile being launched and flying towards a target. Kinzhal reportedly has a range of approximately 1,250 miles or 2,000 kilometers and a top speed of Mach 10. That's more than 10 times the speed of sound. The Sukhoi Su-57 is the fifth-generation, stealthy, single-seat, twin-engine, jet, multi-role fighter aircraft designed for air superiority and ground attack operations. It's the successor of Su-35 and Russia's answer to the American F-35 Lightning II and F-22 Raptor. Its prototype first flew on January 29, 2010, and recently it has seen limited operational deployment in Syria. Russian Air Force has ordered 22 of these for its own use. The MiG-31 carries a single Kinzhal hooked from external hardpoint. The Su-57 stealth profile calls for the weapons to be carried internally. The fighter has weapons bay for this purpose, but those are too small for Kinzhal. Hence, a modified, smaller variant of the Kinzhal missile will have to be designed for the Su-57. There are two major problems in the path. Firstly, earlier this year, it came to light that the Su-57 will not see serial production anytime soon. Russia's defense minister, Yuri Borisov, during an interview with the state-owned Russia 24 television network on July 2, 2018, defending the move, had said, "You know that today the Su-57 is considered to be one of the best aircraft produced in the world. Consequently, it does not make sense to speed up work on mass-producing the fifth-generation aircraft." He was implying that the MiG-29 Fulcrum and Su-35S Flanker E are more than capable of fulfilling Russia's air combat needs. While the assertion may be true to an extent, there are many other reasons for this. This includes budget constraints and issues in developing an engine suitable for fifth-generation fighter. The Su-57 also lacks a fully capable avionics suite. It must be noted here that the Russian Su-57 program had active backing of India. India wanted a customized variant of Su-57 for its air force and had put in significant funding. India had plans to acquire around 150 of these jets. In April of 2018, India pulled out of the project. India had reservations about the engine as well as stealth performance. The Su-57 still needs a significant amount of work and will be available only in limited numbers. The second issue is reducing the size of Kinzhal to accommodate it inside the Su-57's weapons bay. Kinzhal is large for a reason. The large size enables it to have a powerful rocket booster and a decent amount of fuel that enables it to reach hypersonic speed and have a long range. If the size is shrunk, the missile will have to have a smaller booster and less fuel. This, in all probability, will reduce its speed and range, negating the main advantages of the missile. Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting. And
kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.